Royal Heaven.
I don't know what happened.
I'm General Vander, Republic Chief of Operations for Ord Mantell. It's a pleasure to finally meet you. On behalf of the Republic and the people of Ord Mantell, I want to thank and congratulate you for your courageous actions in disabling the stolen ZR system. Your heroic efforts saved countless innocent lives. In recognition of your valiant service, I hereby promote you to the rank of Lieutenant.
Nice.
Congratulations.
I'm honored.
Now, Lieutenant, as the last remaining member of Havoc, the duty of rebuilding the squad falls to you. Havoc is your command. To get the process started, I've decided to assign Sergeant Jorgen here as Havoc's first new member.
Okay.
Glad to have you in the unit, Jorgen.
I'll take the Havoc patch and Sergeant Stripes if it means I get to grind them into Tavis's face before we kill him.
This is the best I can do for you, Jorgen. You're a good man. We need good people now more than ever. I don't know what Tavis is planning, but he knows the inner workings of our military better than anyone. The destruction he could cause is limitless.
I won't allow Tavis and the others to harm the Republic, sir.
But don't. It won't be easy to take down. In any case, your work here is done. I've got a shovel prepped, and you're going to Coruscant for your next assignment. When you arrive on Coruscant, report immediately to the head of Spec Force Division, General Garza. She'll be issuing your orders from now on.
Understood, sir.
Better get your shovel. It's waiting for you in the landing.
Okay.
Lieutenant, Sergeant, you're dismissed. I hope I see you again someday.
You will. Now I'm going to need some water. It should only take a second. Just 1 second.
You better not be turning the water. Dude, I got a helmet. Really dislike Jorgen. So? How does this compare to my boats? That's what I want to know. I just realized I could do that. Since you can, in fact, take their... can, in fact, make outfits and stuff now. It's like, if I had somebody who had a really cool outfit that I just wanted, just take it from them. I don't want to look at his ugly mug. I don't want to see him. He didn't care about that. I know I had another one in there. There you go, buddy. I've got mail. Yes, it did. Why you paid me 77 credits for it, I will never know. Am I done here?
Zips made their charge on this fort once. Souped up spears, a few heavy arms. It didn't go well for them.
Command sending out new tactics all the time.
Cool.
Stay sharp out there.
What? Why is it called that? Move that down. Move that up. Is that all of them? Cool.
Post exchange around. You need it, we got it. Anything a soldier needs, and some things he doesn't. Good luck out there.
I'm like, is that one of them there collections? Nope. Scout, Shakeable, Havoc. That does look more like something that'd be up Heaven Squad's alley. Cool. Okay, let's leave. Where's the shuttle? The whole Bolt Blaster Ensemble. Oh, somebody still has a quest for me, great.
Okay. I practically discovered everything by now. On this planet. Eat some hot Cheetos, drink some drink. I was level 21 trooper, and I already had gotten past Jorgen, and had passed the second one. I'll be honest, I had the robot. Ah, crap. If you play the game, you know what I'm talking about. Are you guys sentient? I had to group these abilities together by a common effect. Like this and this, how to put together. Yes, fire for effect. So close to throw these grenades.
Adam.
I don't really care enough about credits. Just work on healing me, buddy. I wonder if that big, like, other... So I have the artillery blitz. But I wonder if that, if the commando gets a different kind of, like, artillery strike for himself. Not that I don't enjoy that ability. Let's see what's in the demolishers thing. This should be one of those collection things. It's like, guy, I mean, I have all the blast boot thingies. And all the Garnic blast booted things. What more do you want? These are live people. Finesse. This is how I have gotten through many an MMO game. Because I played a lot. I played a lot of them. But like, very fine finesse, where it's like, I know that if I'm exactly this close, it will attack me. So, I'm gonna be like, 0.1 distance away from that said distance. and I will never have to fight anyone if I don't want to. Oh, I can kill one more thing and level up.
Nice to see customers. Can I get you anything?
Oh, I don't care. I don't use dims. I never, ever, 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 ever use dims.
Feel free to browse.
Reminder, mechanized travel is for official business only.
I should probably just use my mini-map. A spicy meatball. Why do I need to check my map when I'm, like, right here? Sure. I'll do it. You know why I do it? Because I don't spend money on anything else anyway. Like, the only time I've ever spent money in an MMO game when I really cared was, like, maybe RuneScape, because I was, like, trying to get, like, a really awesome piece of armor. Or, like, Star Trek Online, because it's like, oh, I realized that I could buy some weapons, and all the weapons I was using were crappy. Whoa, grab a glitch, whoa. Press K for Kilimanjaro. I'm doing cold. Oh, Can I preview these? I'd like to see it. I'm looking at it as close as I can. They both look cool, but I think this is the one that I wore one time. I'll do that one.
On your feet.
What happened?
I need to talk to you in private.
That's fine. I'm all right with that. I guess that works. I mean, not a fan, personally. So, I've had a sudden realization. You're wearing an actual, like, outfit. You have, like, no, you don't have a back thingy. So I don't want your chest plate. But I do want to kind of steal your pants. If you know what I'm saying. Okay. I'm gonna sell these. Because I don't care about them. I'm going to let you keep that. But Jorgen's pants, they're mine. I will not give up my backpack thingy, even if it matches slightly better.
Okay, Jorgen. You can have your pants. And all that jazz. Because I'm not in the mood for this crap. Okay, sweet. This is that. Yes. Excellent. Yeah. All is well and good with the universe.
On your feet.
It just took a while to update. Okay, I dig it. I spent a lot of time screwing around with that. But I dig it. Can you dig it? It's dark in my room, I need to turn the lights on. Can't handle it, switch it out. Where'd my plate go? Oh. It's like... Holy crap. Mail. Care about any of this. I like the free XP. But I don't care. I need to go that way. The mod station. What?
I need to talk to you in private.
What does that mean? It's not like I have a ship or something. What alliance? What's in there? Why are you pounding on the glass? Figure 60 is the number of players here. I've been fooled. Maybe I should just look where I'm going and use the mini-map. But I can't resist. Oh, grand.
I need to talk to you in private.
Kinamabam. Yak Manala. Ogo Gala Apayan. Inilama Ini Amaranga. Nayana Rangam. Kala Ama Nani Mami. Living back.
That's good news.
Mim ilik meraka, nayenaram, kam kalu amik manik, Manala yang perlu. Amka kalami nayakira nebua.
I already did this mission. Just for the, Empire. With a much bigger ship. But of course, it's only fair. Wait. Oh. I might have just... That's why this ship was smaller. I might have just missed the opportunity to do a Flashpoint mission. Crap. No. You will not deny me. I will not be denied. This is probably the Elise SLEs. Well, bam, cutscene. Well, thank you for playing our game. Well, how nice of her. Munch, 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 munch. You all are short. Oh, dude, the guy I can sell this crap to. Droid.
For a moment. You're a soldier, Republic Army, right?
Yes.
I'm sorry to bother you, but I was wondering if you've been contacted by any of the ship's officers.
I've not been contacted by any of the ship's personnel. Is there a situation?
I heard a rumor that there's an Imperial warship following us. I know, the treaty, of course, but I don't trust the Empire to keep the peace.
The imps will always be a threat. No treaty is going to change that.
Good to hear you. I'm concerned about the Imperials. The crew won't tell the passengers anything at all.
Well,
it's not very reassuring.
Telling the passengers that Imperials are nearby would only cause a panic.
I suppose. Still, I think it's unsettling to think that there might be Imperials behind us.
Oh.
Warning! Incoming fire! All hands, brace for incoming! Repeat! All hands!
That's very weak. I would have chosen a lot more of a manly voice actor, or some more stronger dialogue.
Can you hear me? Are you all right?
Imperial seem to have forgotten about the treaty.
I knew the treaty would break eventually, but I didn't think I'd actually be here to see it.
Listen, you have to get to the bridge. The captain will need all of the help he can get right now. Go, hurry. I'll see what I can do.
With your skills, I'm sure you could make a difference. Good luck.
Thank you.
Sniffle, sniffle.
You can make it, sir! You can make it!
It's gone, sir. You're in charge now. What are our orders?
Your orders? Weapons are out! Shields are out! Comms are out! There's nothing we can do!
You need to stay calm.
Holy crap!
Who asked you? We're in the middle of a situation here. The bridge is off limits.
Sir, we need all the help we can get. If we don't keep it together here, we're finished.
Keep what together? The Imperials have us by the throat! We're as good as dead already!
What's wrong with you? Are you really gonna let your ship fall to the Imperials so easily?
That ship behind us is one of the biggest in the Imperial fleet! We didn't stand a chance!
Sir, incoming message. The Imperial ship is hailing us.
What?
Oh, well then put them on.
Republic Transport Angeles, this is Grand Mark Rex. Your defenses are entirely disabled. Attempt no resistance.
Fent Colrin again. Or Kilrin.
We're aware of our situation, Kilrin. Just tell us why you're here.
Your ship is transporting a known anti-imperial terrorist and seditionist, the so-called Ambassador Vin Asara. I've come to collect her.
Who? We didn't take any passengers by that name. I've never even heard of this person.
Interesting. Lying or incompetent, no matter. My agents aboard your ship have confirmed the Ambassador is there.
What are you going to do about it, Kilrin? You can't force us to hand this person over.
I'm fairly confident that I can. Imperial soldiers are preparing to board your ship. My agents will ensure that you do not interfere with them. If you attempt to stop my men from arresting Ambassador Asara, I will have every living being aboard the SS killed.
Where's the primary airlock? I'll stop the Imperials as they try to board.
Weren't you listening? If we try to fight, they'll slaughter us! We have to cooperate!
It won't matter. Kilrin has us now. He'll kill us all. He's famous for it. The only one he wants alive is the Ambassador. If Kilrin gets the Ambassador while we're sitting in his sights, we're goners. Those soldiers have to be stopped before they can succeed.
I can hold the line against a pack of imps any day.
It's very brave of you to volunteer. Listen, I'm sorry I lost it earlier. It means a lot to have your help right now. Thank you.
As a soldier of the Republic, it's my duty to help.
Maybe she so, said the same thing.
We appreciate your help all the same. I'll have our security team meet you by the primary airlock. They haven't seen much action, but Commander Narlok knows his stuff. Good luck. We're all counting on you.
For a second, I thought this was like the mission I played as an Imperial agent in reverse. The first Flashpoint mission you do. I thought it was almost, for a second I was like, are you really gonna do it like copy for copy? It's like, nah, it's still gonna be different. Oh jeez. Kill 'em all. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
it, men. This is what you've been training for. The Imperials are coming, and we're not going to let them pass, are we?
Sir, no, sir!
We aren't fighting alone. An experienced volunteer is going to help us. The imps won't stand a chance.
Let's move on to the task at hand.
Yes, the battle plan. The imps will cut through any second now. We need to take up defensive positions.
Oh, there we go. There's the battle plan. No. You...
It's victory or nothing.
I'm pressing all the buttons that I have on my computer. Are you punk?
Victory or nothing.
Yes, it is. That didn't work.
The bridge. You have to hurry. It was all a trap. The Imperial set us up.
Ambassador, capture her at all costs.
Victory or nothing. Victory or nothing.
Noise. That should help.
Surrender.
Nice.
Victory or nothing.
There we go. I probably could get some help if I just lured them this way. Noise.
Yeah, victory! We've done it, man! We've done it! The ship is saved!
I'm sorry, Commander, but that... that isn't the case.
The Imperial said that you're the one they were sent to capture.
Listen, that's not important right now. We have a serious problem. First Officer Hawken walked us right into a trap. The attack on this airlock was a ruse. After Hawken sent you here, Imperial Commandos snuck aboard. They were led by a Mandalorian mercenary called Iron Fist.
You must be joking.
You're kidding me. It gets worse, I'm afraid. Iron Fist and his Imperial Commandos stormed the bridge, and now the entire area is locked down tight.
We have to stop the Imperials from gaining control of the ship.
That's why I rushed to find you. Something has to be done.
What is this all about? Why are the Imperials so desperate to capture you?
Because of my work. I'm a Republic ambassador. I travel to Imperial-controlled planets and convince their governments to come over to our side.
You should have identified yourself earlier, ma'am. I could have better ensured your safety.
I appreciate your concern, but this is no time to play bodyguard. We have bigger problems.
We need to retake the bridge. The longer we leave the Imperials in control, the harder it'll be to remove them.
I already told you, Iron Fist has the bridge locked down. There's no way in or out.
Ha!
Security lockdown. That is bad. Chief Engineer Salen might know of a workaround.
Hopefully we can get to Salem before the Imperials. Do you know where he is?
He and his team will be down in the engineering section. I'm sure they'll be able to help us.
We'll need a diversion. If the Imperials notice the hatches to engineering opening, they'll flood the area with soldiers.
My men and I can handle that. Form up, men! We're gonna go start some trouble.
Let's get that bridge open.
We'll give those imps something to think about, won't we, boys?
I'll go along with Commander Narlock. Once you've cleared a path to engineering, I'll double back and join up with you there.
They're gonna have a fun time. They got a pretty big team of guys ready.
And clones and such to go with it.
Let's go. Whoa. Why can't I shoot? I think I had jargon selected. There we go. That worked. Gross.
Coming all the way down here with the imps everywhere.
Commander Narlock said that you might know of a way to unlock the bridge. The Imperials have sealed it off.
The imps pulled the lockdown? You gotta be kidding me.
You really cleared this place out. I didn't run into a single Imperial on my way down here. Listen, there's no time to waste. Commander Narlock and his men are being overrun. We have to get the bridge unlocked now.
So I've heard. Let you in, but the lockdown has our door sealed too.
Are you going to be safe in there? Do you need help getting out?
Getting the bridge back in our control is much more important. Now let's see.
What about a reactor reset? That would disengage the security locks, wouldn't it, sir?
Yeah, but a reactor reset vents the engineering compartment. We'd be blown into space. Besides, controls are on the other side of the door.
I don't want to kill you guys.
tell your lackeys to shut up unless they have ideas we can actually use.
Dang.
He was just trying to help. Besides, he gave me an idea.
The secondary conduits. They're spread around a bit, but if you shut them all down, the security will go down too. Then we'll be in business.
I'll get the conduits shut down right away.
There's no time to go running all over the ship. If we don't act now, the Imperials will overwhelm us. I'm sorry, Salem. We need to unlock the bridge while we have the chance. We have to reset the reactor. You and your men will be remembered.
We can't send these people to their deaths. Not when there's an alternative.
Fine. But you're dooming everyone on this ship. Sometimes sacrifices have to be made for the greater good.
I make the decisions, Ambassador. Not you.
Boom.
Fine. Who am I to argue?
You crazy witch! Shutting down the secondary conduits will work, I promise!
If you're going to do it, go now. The longer you wait, the more Imperials you have after you.
Let's go. Time for you guys. Dead. Didn't help. Oh, geez. Go away. A good part of doing this is like when I get back to Coruscant and the Republic, I can say I did a good bit more than just what up my work on Ord Mantell. And more than just, oh, I'm a member of Havoc. No. Not that that's realistically such a bad thing, like, just like it's in the army, the Corps, and all branches of the military. It's not, you know, it's managing to get into the Rangers or the Green Berets or what have you. That's respectable in and of itself. It's just for everyone who's already in.
I don't know how you managed it, but you did.
They've all done it. So at that point, you have to set a new standard. I mean, especially being in a unit like that, it's like, okay, you're in now. No, what's the bar now? Because I'm sure, like, the bar you had was get in, you know, work your hardest, get in. Well, now that you're in, what are you going to do next? So, I mean, my character's in Havoc Squad. That's pretty respectable by me. That's it? What have you done? Since technically I'm like an 18 X-ray, I went straight from basic to being in the unit.
The bridge is open, and no innocent lives had to be sacrificed to do it.
You were right. I'm sorry. Please understand, I didn't want to kill anyone.
Yes, you did.
It seemed like the only way to be sure. I'll go and help Narlok with another diversion, so you have as little resistance as possible when you attack the bridge. You'll still have to deal with Iron Fist, though, and that's no small challenge.
Iron Fist is nothing.
There's nobody I can't handle. That's good. Most people would panic when faced with an experienced Mandalorian. Or any Mandalorian, really. I only know Iron Fist by reputation. But he's been doing Grand Moff Kilrin's dirty work for a long time now. He's never been captured, defeated, or even driven back. You have your work cut out for you. Just kill him like I kill everyone else who gets in my way. Just be careful. Mandalorians always have a few tricks up their sleeves. All right. No more time to waste. Narlok, are you there? Can you hear me?
Copy. This is Narlok. Set for second offensive.
That's right, Commander. I'm on my way to join you now.
All right. Let's move.
Good luck.
This could get interesting, though. For sure. It was cool watching her pump it like a shotgun. But not exactly what I meant to do. Dang. And the funny thing is, Mandalorians have a reputation, like, in the saga, like, the current era, I guess. You know. Of the new Old Republic. So basically, like, even in the Old Republic games, the Mandalorians have a history. So, imagine how much of a history they have, considering that in, you know, the movie series, and the time period, you know, movies take place in, they're considered a people with a long history. Like, they must have some kind of insane amounts of history. Like, insane. Each of these people are Mandalorian, and each of them is dead. Defeat Mandalorian commandos. Oh. Yeah. This song is old. You can always tell when a song is meant for Star Wars. I think. I figured I'd see a whole bunch of just blue lights everywhere. Whoa. Okay, bros. You'd think that, considering that these guys are people who respect strength, that my abilities in combat would make them want to join me. What kind of clap is that?
Well, well. I was wondering when you'd finally show up. This is it? There aren't more of you?
Go ahead then. Show me what you got.
Let's vape this worthless scum and get back to work.
Oh. Here, buddy. Nice.
First Officer Hawken, do you have any spare shuttles in the hangar bay?
Spare shuttles? Yes, we do, but I don't...
Then that's our only chance. You have to board Grand Moff Kilburn's ship and disable the tractor beam so that we can all escape.
Gotcha.
Head on assault, surgical strike, and rapid exfiltration. No problem.
I knew we could count on you.
Why are you graphically bugged?
The tractor beam control should be easy to find if you know where you're going.
Ambassador, you're familiar with the layout. Perhaps you should go along to help get the tractor beam shut down.
We need every advantage we can get.
It'll be good to have you along, Ambassador.
I'll do my best to help in any way I can.
Ambassador, before you go, take a spare uniform. We wouldn't want any Imperials to recognize you.
Good thinking, Commander. Thank you. Now let's get moving.
What is that gonna do?
Good luck out there. We're all counting on you.
Sure. Right? I can dig it. I can dig it.
Hey, hold up a minute. I need to talk to you before you go.
Yeah.
I just talked to Salen from engineering. He told me what Asara tried to make you do down there. Thank you for stopping.
Sacrificing innocent people is wrong, no matter the reason.
You stood up for the lives of my crew, and risked your own instead. I won't forget that. Listen, I've been thinking. I really believe this plan is going to work. But there's only one way to guarantee that we'll all make it home safe. And that's to make sure the Imperials have no reason to keep chasing us.
It is.
You want me to hand the Ambassador over to the Imperials, don't you?
Yes. For the sake of us all, I want you to leave Asara behind, on the Grand Moff ship. With the tractor beam down, we'll be able to escape, but Kilrin will just chase us down again, unless he's already captured his target. As long as Asara is on this ship, everyone aboard is in danger. I don't know about you, but I'm tired of risking all of our lives for that woman.
I I didn't sacrifice the engineers to get us out of this. I won't sacrifice Asara either.
Just think about it. I'd even make it worth your while if things go the way I'm suggesting. Anyway, you better get going. I've held you up too long already. Good luck.
It's just gonna give me a moral choice later. BioWare's cool like that. I was trying to remember, like, whenever I see game logos like BioWare and them, I'm like, I'm trying to remember what the heck it is they made. I'm like, oh, I get freedom to make choices and stuff, and dialogue? This must be some kind of, like, the company that made Mass Effect, maybe. Maybe. Especially considering the fact that Commander Shepard is in this. I wonder what the male character sounds like. I like the voice actor for the Imperial Agent. Mostly because I like the accent. Oh, we're already here. This is another thing I didn't like about games like this. Why have I not leveled up? They change the name and the level of a character. Well, they change the level of a character and they give it a new name accordingly. And yet, the model for it is the exact same. I guess I'm expected to kill all these guys. Okay. I like the weapons that have like area effect damage, because it allows me to fight in depth, which is attacking a whole unit. We're doing damage to a whole unit instead of just part of a unit, or like the front line of a unit. Combat in depth. Yeah. Something along those lines. I read about it in the book. Which is like why. The reason why, like, tactics like the Russians used to use, the human wave tactics were so effective is because if you weren't fighting in depth, all you were doing is attacking that first wave, whereas they were attacking, like, if you were defending, they were either attacking your whole line, which was just a really stretched out front. Or they were kind of doing the same, attacking your front line. It's just that there's wave after wave after wave, and usually for the U.S., you know, we didn't do the human wave tactic, so they were just attacking our whole units while their only the front line was taking damage. I mean, if we had actually had fought, that is. But fighting in depth is attacking the front, middle, and back of that unit, so that way when they actually get to your lines, or if they already are at your lines, you're not just attacking part of it and leaving fresh troops to fight you. When the first wave finally is defeated, the second wave won't be a bunch of fresh troops. They'll already be pretty hurt themselves. the unit outright. Yes. And most of this is achieved through effective use of air power, artillery, and maneuver. Oh my gosh. This is the only thing about the MMO games like this. With the combat, it's like, there's really no way that, like, they're gonna beat me. But I still have to go through the monotony of slowly but surely knocking down their health piece by piece. It's a lot more intense where they have a good chance of killing me. We don't have time to deal with you guys. Of course, I'm going to level up with the amount of slaughtering I've been doing.
Some incredible things in my time, but you just topped the list. I'm sorry I couldn't greet you in person. If only you had let me know you were stopping by.
This is a bad time. We could come back later.
Oh, no, not at all, I assure you. I'm quite prepared for your visit. My men will be along shortly to escort you to the accommodations I've arranged.
Okay, sure.
Your men can't stop us, Kilran.
You greatly overestimate your chances. Iron Fist wasn't the only weapon in my arsenal, nor the deadliest. See you soon.
Cool. I don't care.
I wonder if, like, how, if this wasn't, like, an MMO, like, how would this look? How would this play out for real, where I'd actually be as successful as I was? What would this look like if it was slightly more realistic, or even capable of making sense? Taking them out one by one. I feel like I've been too quiet. Too quiet. Keep doing that. I'm probably not dying as much because I just have a, like, I don't think I had my character set to heal me like I did before. Jogging. I wonder why that's true, why that happened.
feel like I'm interrupting it. Like when I use that ability. I want to know something. If I just let it go, will it do more? Yeah, it did a little bit more. Got knocked. Like, if I fired a slug at him, I fired a slug right into him, blasting him into that chair. Hey, buddy. Norna. I was like, this thing can't be a battle droid. All it's got is just this punch. It's more like a construction working brawl. Noise. To do something.
Oh my gosh. I wonder what this terminal is. Huh. I want to know. It has to be something that I can physically reach in this, that little time window. Yeah, I have to go through here. There we go. Guys, I gotta show you guys my Commander Shepard sometime. Did I ever do that? I don't know if I did a video in between. I should have though. I totally should have made a video of me playing Mass Effect. Yeah.
I was like, don't you dare shoot at that. It's just gonna follow us unless I kill it. That was proving to be very ineffective. No. Ow. No! Oh, this is nasty. He's on to me. He's realized that I've fled. Yeah, it didn't fire all the burst because I accidentally... Well, I interrupted. My bullets are auto-tracking. Well, of course I would. I mean, I am pretty much just running through your entire ship, killing lots of crewmen, and destroying many valuable droids. Not really enough crewmen to make a difference, but the droids are valuable. And training the troops is expensive. Just more of a cost. I'm doing more damage in the long run, I guess, than the short term. Because there are a lot of dead officers, for sure. Like, the ship will be just fine, is what I'm saying. But... not easy to replace for sure. Oh. You're gonna die as soon as the rest.
Greetings. A soldier? What a waste. No soldier can match the power of a Sith.
You must not have heard of Havoc Squad.
I don't waste my time with trivial nonsense. To destroy a dangerous foe, that is the way of a true Sith. You are nothing less than me.
Huh. I'll do my best to spare you the embarrassment.
Such witticisms will not save you. The power of the dark side is infinite. Are you ready to face oblivion?
Big talk with nothing to back it up. Always entertaining.
You're right. Words are nothing without action.
Okay, guys. Oh, I don't know. Never mind. Still all your lackeys, that's a good idea. That way they can't shoot me. I don't know what I did. The funny thing about the escape abilities, I have no idea what I'm actually doing to help myself escape. I do know this. This guy is not getting out of here alive. No-brainer. Shoot him. So how'd you beat this guy? I ran circles around the dude, gunning him down while he tried to cut me up with his lightsaber. And whenever he tried to freaking get me, I just moved. I outmaneuvered him, and I launched grenades at him, and slugs at him, and I used toxic. I don't know. I'm trying to come up with like a neat kind of explanation for the escape ability. I always imagine it's like the same like.
I'm charging up our main turbo laser's batteries. In a few moments, your pathetic ship and all your pathetic friends will be nothing but floating debris.
That's a lot of pathetic in that sentence. I'll tell you one thing, though.
Come on, get onto the shuttles. We have to hurry.
Okay.
If we launch fast enough, I think we can make it. Are you ready?
Right behind you, Ambassador.
Let's just hope Hawken has the hyperdrive ready. Come on.
I wonder what it was that we needed to talk about. Oh, leaving you behind. Ha ha ha. But it's like, you know, you throw like the old trick of throwing sand in someone's eyes. It's like that. I'm like using a tool that I have as a soldier and I'm just freaking blinding them. I didn't do the thing with the computers because I didn't figure it out and I was confused as all I could get out. I did the other stuff. I need more water.
I'm gonna die of dehydration. Somehow my last character managed to get like 1,000 kills with Jargon and near like 600 kills with my
Everyone's
other
aboard,
companion.
Get us out of here now.
Peace. I'm surprised that a little.
We're safe. You did it. You did what no one else could have done. You've saved us all. We owe you our lives. Every one of us. So on behalf of the passengers and crew of the Republic Transport Essilus, thank you.
It's been an honor to help and protect you all.
If you hadn't been here, we'd all have been doomed. We can't thank you enough. I took up a collection from everyone on the ship. Hopefully these credits will help you save other people in need, the same way you saved us.
Please, keep your credits. I'm sure you all need them more than me.
That's extremely gracious of you. Thank you very much.
You, skulking around.
Ambassador Asara, it's a relief to see that you made it back to us safely as well.
It's a relief to be back, Hawken. I'm just glad that this is all finally over. We're finally safe. I want to thank you again for everything you've done. Heroes like you are hard to come by, and the Republic needs everyone they can get.
I just did my job.
I mean it. If you hadn't been here, we would all be dead for certain. I should warn you, though. Grandmaster Kilrun is never going to forget what we've done. He'll stop at nothing to get his revenge.
If Kilrun wants to try me again, that's fine. Just be sure to stay alert from now on. Kilrun is full of surprises. Anyway.
You can try.
I'd say it's about time we all relaxed a bit and enjoyed the rest of our trip. Thanks again. And good luck in the future.
So I think what they're saying is, I could have run on a little shuttle and been like, it's fast, but it's like, it's like, it'll take a few days, but it's nice and luxurious, and it's a cruiser. Oh man, come on. Yes. I'm surprised that a hammerhead, they call it a hammerhead cruiser, I think, but it's pretty effective. Could survive that long. I mean, I've played enough Empire at War to know. It's like, frigates don't last long against fully fledged. Like, that was a Star Destroyer. Though, considering. Considering this is the Old Republic, it could just be that a proportions thing. That thing could have looked massive compared to our little hammerhead. But, in all actuality, if you compared, like, that ship to a Imperial Star Destroyer, it could turn out that, like, that cruiser is actually just a frigate in comparison. Sort of like an acclimator, perhaps. A really beefy, beefed out acclimator. Ah! Always do that. Thank you, Jargon. You're a heck of a lot less annoying than you have been.
On your feet.
A custom. Oh.
Wow. Spent enough time on a backwater like Ord Mantell, you almost forget what a civilized planet's supposed to look like. I did my officer training here, back before I was deployed to Ord Mantell. There was still a fair bit of reconstruction going on then, rebuilding things the Imperials destroyed. I still can't believe the Empire managed to sack Coruscant back in the war. The capital of the entire Republic, and they raided it like some Outer Rim mudball.
It's a good thing we got it back.
Seems like the Empire would have tried to hold on to Coruscant.
Nah, they didn't bring the numbers to actually take over. It was a psych-op. Sack Coruscant, scare everyone in the Republic. Get people thinking that nobody's safe. Anyways, we should get moving. Don't want to keep anyone important waiting.
That's actually a really smart thing to do. Like, we did that plenty of times, Japan. Mostly because, like, the way we were fighting the Japanese, that was, like, the only way we were going to do it. Because we do something to break their, unbreakable spirit. For it was surely unbreakable.
Ah, you're here. It's a great pleasure to meet one of the Republic's finest. I realize you can't discuss it, Lieutenant, but thank you for exposing the traitors on Ord Mantell.
If you know about that, you also know I've got unfinished business.
I'm not here to keep you from that. I represent Venara Kale, Senator of Coruscant. She not only speaks for our capital world in the Galactic Senate, but oversees this planet's government.